we'll go over how to write the electron configuration for both the full and the abbreviated electron configuration for these four elements. That's an example from each block, S, P, D, and F. This will get you ready for your next quiz or test on electron configuration. Before we start, let's identify the different blocks in the periodic table. This is the S block, and this is the P block. Transition metals are the D block, and the inner transition metals are the F block. To write the electron configuration, you'll need to know the relationship between the energy level and the period number. Period are the rows indicated here, 1 to 7. For S block, the energy level is the same as the period number. Same goes for P block. D block is minus 1, which means the energy level is period number minus 1. For F, it's minus 2, which means the energy level is period number minus 2. Now, this relationship may not make much sense right now, but hang in there because we're going to use example and then it's going to make perfect sense. So we'll start with beryllium, which is element number 4. Since its atomic number is 4, that means beryllium atom has 4 electrons. It's located here in the S block, so we start by writing S. And then beryllium is located in period 2, which is row number 2. So for S block, the relationship between the energy level and the period number is the same. So which means, since beryllium is in period 2, we're going to write 2 in front of S. And then notice that beryllium is the second member in the S block, so we're going to write a superscript 2 above like that. So now that we've located beryllium, let's complete the entire electron configuration for beryllium. Starting from the first row, which is period number 1, we have S block, and then we have two elements in the S block, so we're going to write a superscript 2 above like that. In fact, with that, we are actually done writing the electron configuration for beryllium, because it only has 4 electrons. How do we know that we already wrote the complete electron configuration? Well, you add up all the numbers in the superscripts, and that should be equal to the number of electrons that you're writing for. So for beryllium, 1s2, 2s2, that 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, which is equal to the 4 in beryllium. So we're done writing the full electron configuration for beryllium. If you're asked to write the abbreviated or noble gas, abbreviated, shorthand, condensed electron configuration, whatever that it's called, I got you covered. So what you want to do is you want to locate the noble gas in the previous period. So beryllium is in period 2, the noble gas in period 1 is going to be helium. So what you do is you write helium in square bracket like this. Helium basically represents 1s2. Now we write whatever that's left. So now that we've already addressed 1s2, what's left is 2s2. That basically is it. That's the abbreviated electron configuration for beryllium. Let's move on to slightly harder, which is sulfur, element number 16, located here in the P block. So again, let's go through the same exercise. We start by locating sulfur, which is in the P block. And then notice the relationship between the energy level and the period number is the same for P block. So sulfur is located in period 3. So we write a 3 in front of P. And we count where sulfur is in the P block. Sulfur turns out to be the 4th member in the P block. So we write a superscript 4 above like that. So that's sulfur's location, 3P4. Now we start from the very beginning with period number 1. Now period 1, we have S block and there are 2 elements there, right? So we have 1S2. Moving on to the second period, the first block that we encounter is S and there are 2 elements there as well. So we write 2S2. And then we move on, we're not done with period 2 yet because there's that P block. And in P block, there are 6 elements. You can basically just count the boxes. There are 6 boxes in the P block. So we have 2P6. And that pretty much covers period 2. And now we move on to period 3. And then the first one that we encounter is 3S. And there are 2 elements there, so that's 3S2. Next would be 3P, and we've already addressed that. So with that, we've written the full electron configuration for sulfur. To write the abbreviated electron configuration, so the noble gas in period 2 is neon. So we write neon in square bracket. Neon basically covers 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. It covers everything up to period 2. So then we continue on to whatever that's left in period 3, which is 3s2, 3p4. And that's the abbreviated electron configuration for sulfur. Next, we move on to titanium. Titanium has 22 electrons located here. That's in D block, so we write D. Now notice the relationship between the energy level and period is minus 1. So which means even though titanium is in period 4, the energy level, the number we're going to write in front of D is not going to be 4. It's going to be 4 minus 1. So that's 3. And then titanium happens to be the second member. So we're going to write a superscript 2 like that. So we've already located titanium. Now let's complete the electron configuration by starting all the way from the top. So again, period 1, there's only 2 members in S block. So that's 1s2. And then we go to period 2. Period 2, the first thing we encounter is the S block, 2s2. And then next we move on to the P block, which has 6 members. So that's 2p6. And then we go on to period 3. The first thing we encounter is the S block. So that's 3s. And there are 2 elements in there. So 3s2. And then we move on to the P block, and there are 6 elements there, so 3P6. And then we get to period 4, that's S block, 2 elements, so that's 4S2. And then we enter into the D block, which we have already addressed for the titanium. So with that, this is the full electron configuration for titanium. To write the abbreviated electron configuration, titanium is in period 4, so the noble gas in period 3 is argon. So we write AR in square bracket. That pretty much covers everything in period 3, which is up to 3p6. Now what's remaining would be 4s2 and 3d2. This is the abbreviated electron configuration for titanium. Now we move on to an example from the F block, which is element number 99, has 99 electrons. So this is going to be a good test to see if you fully understood what we've covered so far. In fact, if you want to pause this video, go ahead and do that and then come back and check whether you got it right or not. So I'm going to go ahead and get started and figure out the location of ES element number 99, which is right here. The next thing I want to do is I want to locate where is ES. ES is part of the inner transition metal, which comes from here. So ES in period 7 and it's in F block. So we're going to start with F, and then remember the relationship for F block is period number minus 2 for the energy level. So period number is 7 minus 2, that will be 5. So we're going to write a 5 in front of F. And if you count all the boxes leading up to ES, that will be 11. And to complete the electron configuration, we're going to start all the way from the top. So period 1, there's only S and there are 2 elements, 1s2. Period 2, we have S block, which has 2 elements, and then followed by 2p, which has 6 elements. And then we move on to period 3, which has 2 elements in the S block. And then 3p, we have 6 elements there. And then we move on to period 4. Again, it's 4s2. And then we go inside this D block. Don't forget that for D block, it's period minus 1. So it's not 4D. Instead, it should be 3D. And there are 10 elements there. So it's 3D10. And then after that, we proceed to the P block in period 4. So P block, period number and energy level is the same, right? So we go back to 4 and it's 4p6. Now that we've already covered period 4, let's go on to period 5. So again, it's 5s2. And then again, we venture inside the D block, which is minus 1, right? So that's 4d10. And then we go back out into the P block, which is 5p6. And then we go on to the next period, which is 6s2. And then there's that inner transition F block that we need to address. So we're going to look over here. F is going to be minus 2. So instead of 6, it will be 6 minus 2. That will be 4F. And then there are 14 elements there. So 4F14. And then we go into the D block in period 6. So 6 minus 1, that's 5D. And D can hold 10 elements. So it's 5D10. And then after that, we go into the P block, which is 6P6. And we're almost there. We go to the last period, which is 7, and that's 7s2. So this is the full electron configuration for einsteinium. Did you get this right? Now, it takes a little bit of time for us to write out the full electron configuration. You want to make sure that you get all those energy levels right, because that's usually where mistakes happen. To write the abbreviated electron configuration, it's much easier. Notice that ES is located in period 7. So to write the abbreviated electron configuration, we need the noble gas, which is in period 6, which is Rn. So write Rn in square bracket. That pretty much addresses everything up to period 6, which means that's up to that 6p block, which is pretty much everything right here. What's left is just 7s2 and 5f11. So that's the abbreviated electron configuration for element 99. The method that we've just used applied to most of the elements in the periodic table except for these 21 elements. I've compiled them in my blog. You can check them out if you're interested.